Hey, it's your mean mom, you little shits. That was mean and I'm sorry. I am just back from my holidays, first of many, this summer. And obviously I did not take a sewing machine with me, so I had 2 weeks to think about my project for the Stripey Challenge. If you don't know what I'm talking about, what was that? If you don't know what I'm talking about, check out the video I did 2 weeks ago, I think that was right before I left, about the Stripey Challenge, explaining what it is. So I had one idea in mind when I was setting up the challenge, and then I was like, no, I'm gonna do more research, I'm gonna have a look at more inspirations, because there are so many eras that used stripes as a popular pattern. There are so many beautiful portraits and designs to choose from, so I was like, I'm gonna do research first and then decide. But it turns out I still picked the first idea because I had a look at some 1890s dresses that I was really drawn to, but nothing really inspired me enough to like undertake this. What I chose is... I'm not even making sound with this. What is this? I chose an Emily Fluga 1909 dress. Now, if you don't know who that lady was, don't worry, because I had no clue either. When a couple of years ago I visited Vienna and we went to a museum and there were loads of beautiful photographs, and some of them featured a woman that was dressed in this really like particular way, and it really did not look like anything 1900s I've seen before. So I was quite interested in that, and also there was this one picture of her H-E-R. I can't even spell it properly. And she was wearing a stripy dress, and I remember going like, not only is she completely badass for all these looks, but also stripes. Then I kind of forgot about her, and then I think I read an article about her or something. Like, I knew she existed. She was a fashion designer in 1900s Vienna, and she was a friend of Gustav Klimt, and I think that's why she was featured on the exhibition. But anyway, it wasn't until this year when I had to dig up more information about her, because I was working on another big project that I'm not gonna share any details of. Why do I look like an old person today? I look like I'm using the FaceApp filter. Except I'm not. So anyway, oh my goodness, no, you do not move from here. So I did remember about this one particular photo, and yeah, I'm doing it. I'm doing Emily Fluga's reformed dress, whatever the hell that is, because that's the thing. She was not wearing mainstream fashion. Like, if you have a look at 1909 dresses, what people actually wore at the time, it differs greatly. It does not look like that at all. She had her own style, which is pretty amazing. If you have a look at her pictures, there is this one particular model, it seems, that she loved the most, which is a tight upper bodice, tight top sleeves, and then some ruffled oversleeves and a huge A-line skirt. So in her case, the skirt started like right at the armpits, so it's pretty high. They're really loose and they're also quite wide. So obviously if you compare that to the tight waist of the your usual Edwardian fashion, it does not really... it's not the same. There was a fashion movement at the time called the reformed fashion. Some of the dresses at the time, especially in German-speaking countries, did not accentuate the waist. They were called reformed dresses. They usually had an empire waistline, sort of like the raised waistline, and they were not tied around the waist or bodice. But her dresses, though, do not look like that anyway. Like, if you have a look at reformed dresses of the time, they are almost in this kind of classical style, like they're kind of really smart looking, whereas her dresses are all over the top and there's a lot going on. There's a lot of details, there's a lot of contrasting colors. Now obviously, because it's a reformed dress, at least I think, and at least that's what I gathered from having a look at other photographs of Emily, where she's wearing even looser robes, I'm guessing she would not have been wearing a regular corset underneath, stuff like that. She would either go corsetless, or because she was so used to wearing corset before, she would go with some type of like bra support garment, which were also quite popular at the time. I stumbled upon this one illustration showing like a reformed dress bra, but I'm not going to attempt to make it because it's not gonna make any difference in this case, because the top, like the bodice, is gonna end before the bust itself. So I think I'm just gonna skip this one. I thought that she had to use some sort of skirt support because the skirt looks quite wide. What is really difficult with this photograph is that it's not full size. What I mean is that it ends at her knees, approximately, so I have to guess what the bottom of the dress would be like. And also it would be useful to see the dress from the back and have a look at how it's closed, etc. But I can't do that, so I'm just gonna have to improvise. So based on other photographs of her designs, I guess that the silhouette would be sort of A-line, but also getting a little bit wider right before hitting the ground. Construction-wise, I have no idea how to achieve that without having too many seams, because I don't want to destroy the stripe pattern. She does not seem to have many seams. Stripes are just vertical, there isn't any chaos going on, there is only one point where the stripes go a bit crazy, and that's when I figured is where you could add maybe an A-line panel to make it wider. I don't know, I'm gonna have to figure it out. My fabric just arrived and I haven't really unpacked it because I was too excited, but I had a look and it's glorious. I was thinking of using striped silk because that's what it looks like on the photograph. There is this one place, I had a look at this photo a lot for the past 2 weeks, if you can't tell. There is this point where the fabric is really shiny and I think that means it must have been made of silk. But then I thought, if I'm gonna ruin it, and it's gonna be a very expensive mistake. And also I would have to wait for like at least 2 to 3 weeks till the silk arrives, and I did not really feel like waiting that long. So instead I bought striped cotton, which was like 10 times cheaper, literally, and it looks just as good. It honestly looks amazing. I kind of measured the stripes based on the portrait. Like, I had a look at how wide the stripes are in comparison to her eye. I literally did that, and I came up with 2.5 centimeters wide stripes, which is around 1 inch. So I ordered 10 meters of this because I had no idea how much I'm gonna use, and I thought if I make a mistake I can use some more fabric, and then if I have any leftovers, like, who wouldn't want some leftover black and white striped fabric? So, but it is a lot of fabric though. It looks weird on camera. It's not that pale gray, it's actually like really vibrant black here. Yay, it smells awesome. So yeah, so undergarments wise, I thought I'm gonna have to make a petticoat, and I did. It needs a couple of adjustments though. Here it is. That's a roughly hem. So I based it on a drawing that I found in a fashion magazine, in a German fashion magazine, that showed a reformed style petticoat, so I thought that's quite close to what I'm looking for. But then I had to modify it, obviously, because reformed dresses were not that wide. But basically it featured those shoulder straps that went below the bust. So this is my beautiful design. I came out with 3 panels. It basically looks like a Regency petticoat, except it has a lot more volume at the bottom. The mistake I made is I gathered the fabric at the waistband / under bust band instead of pleating it, and that added some volume under the arms, which I'm not happy with, but hopefully the dress will cover that because it's so wide anyway. I already ripped the waistband at the front because I need to adjust it. What are those things? So I'm hoping this would be enough. Striped cotton is quite sturdy, so maybe it would have enough volume. So here is my breakdown of the outfit. The problem with this outfit is that it has a lot of stuff apart from the dress that's going on. So it has like pleated organza sleeves, like 3 layers. It has those square jewelry pieces that I have no idea where I'm gonna get, and it also has the world's most complex hat, which is tulle or organza ribbon. I don't know, it's gonna be fun. Construction wise, I'm going to have to experiment because I don't really see how that even matches any dress that I've seen. And also I'm gonna have to cheat because the fabric on the photograph, you have the stripes, but then you can see sort of like a line where the stripes are a little bit moved. I don't even know how to call it. But then I'm gonna have to, what I came up with is, instead of trying to make first level of the skirt and then adding the bottom separately, I'm gonna do that with the fabric first, and then I'm gonna sew it as one piece of fabric. So I'm gonna have to cut the fabric in half, sew it together, adjusting the stripes so they're not even, and then I'm gonna sew from there. It's a lot of work, but there is some time. I have some time still. What I'm most worried about is not even the construction, it's not finding the right fabric for it. Especially the hats and like the lace. These are all some really specific types of fabrics. So yeah, that's my project. It's so heavy. Keep updating me on your projects. The challenge is raging on Instagram. Everyone is doing something. A couple of things are already done, including this beautiful Leo de Merode blouse and this Coco Chanel 1930s blouse. Some people are making shoes, some people are making menswear, some people are making waistcoats. It's absolutely amazing. I am blown away, honestly. I'm not good at showing my excitement, but I'm absolutely excited about all of the people participating, and I'm so happy that some of you are trying sewing for the first time for this challenge. And even if nothing works out, it's still a valuable experience, I hope, for you. And I might use that for a different project. And if you're not doing the challenge yet, there's plenty of time. You have time until the end of September. Let me get it right this time because I messed it up on Instagram. So feel free to join us and make a stripy garment. If you don't know what the rules are, check out my stripy challenge video. That's gonna be linked in the description. I just keep playing with the fabric, like I'm not doing anything suspicious here. And have fun with us. Now I need to put all of this away so I can work on other stuff that I need to finish before Monday. So I made a mess.